Each summer, the Dorchester-based Brown Box Theater Project closes its season with its flagship production, bringing a Shakespearean play to locations that ordinarily lack access to live theater. This year, the young cast company will present Cymbeline, King of Britain, whose wild plot brims with forbidden romances, mistaken identities, jealousy, poison, disguises, and epic sword fights. Joining me now to discuss this less frequently produced fairy tale is the director of Cymbeline, Kyler Totson, who is also the artistic director and founder of Brown Box. Good to see you again.
You as well.
All right, let's talk about this play. I mean, many people haven't seen a Shakespeare play, much less Cymbeline, which is a little bit unusual. How do you take that into account as director?
Well, we are always working very hard to make our Shakespeare accessible to everyone, and that's really the mission of the entire company. So no matter whether we're doing a play like Cymbeline, which is rarely produced, or doing something that is more well-known, we're working really hard to make sure that people can come, they can enjoy it, whether they've seen all the Shakespeare in the past or whether they're still new to it. So we're really working hard to just make it open and accessible to anyone, no matter what their attraction is to the work itself.
Now, especially us older folks like it when younger folks do Shakespeare and go to Shakespeare. Now, you have a young cast, right?
Yes.
So does that help younger people say, oh, this isn't stuffy and musty and all that stuff? They're seeing young people doing these parts and doing all kinds of action here.
We always attract really young and excited new talent, many of them fresh out of college. And what's exciting about that is it both attracts a new audience, but it also just keeps some fresh energy and blood in the work itself. And this year, what's so exciting about Cymbeline is that it really does encapsulate so many of the things that everyone can love about Shakespeare, whether it's the forbidden romance of Romeo and Juliet or the intricate father-daughter relationships that you would see in King Lear, sword fighting like Macbeth, or the manipulation that you see in something like Othello. This really wraps it all up into one tight package.
Now, even though the play is named for Cymbeline, King of Britain, the character with the most lines is Imogen, and she's probably the most interesting character. So could you just give us a brief introduction to this complicated plot through the character of Imogen?
Sure. So Imogen is, at the top of the play, has just married her true love, Posthumus, who is a poor young man who was brought up by the king, but is not of noble blood.
Uh-oh.
Exactly. No. So forbidden romance begins right at the top, and Cymbeline banishes him right at the very beginning.
Uh-oh.
And their relationship is tried and tested by a series of very manipulative folks like Iachimo, who basically bets with her husband that he can try and woo Imogen and have her be unfaithful. And while he may fail, he proves to Posthumus otherwise. So that manipulation of the truth comes in pretty early as well. And war comes along with the Romans, and it just everything kind of ensues while she's running away from court trying to prove herself and her loyalty to her husband as well.
All right. Now, Shakespeare is a traditional, obviously, play. But just to give folks an idea of what you do throughout the year, this is your concluding production of the season, your big free Shakespeare. Mm-hmm. What other sorts of plays do you do each year?
We do a variety of contemporary scripts, whether they're world premieres or they are published scripts. And what really that gives our audiences a great diverse array of work, whether it's comedies, tragedies, again, world premiere, new work. We like to give our audience, both here in Boston and to all of the locations that we tour, a great new, different variety of work. And then again, we always come back with Shakespeare at the end of that to keep that ball rolling and keep the Shakespeare spirit alive.
Now, last year you did some stuff in Spanish, multilingual things. Mm-hmm. Just to conclude here, your company travels to the Delmarva Peninsula and does things there. But here in Boston, you're having more venues, or greater Boston, right? You're expanding the places. You're bringing Shakespeare to different Boston neighborhoods and even New England neighborhoods, right?
Yes. So we'll be in Southie, in Dorchester, Hyde Park. We're going this year to Plymouth at Plymouth Rock, as well as Fall River, and out to Hopkinton. So we have a bigger reach here on the eastern areas of Massachusetts, and we'll be reaching as many communities as we can. We'll be out at Castle Island again this year, and you can find all of those dates and details.
All right. That brings me to my final question.
Yes.
Very good. What is your website, and how can people find out more about Cymbeline and your company?
They can visit brownboxtheater.org, where they can find all the dates and details of all of our different locations, including some of the rain locations that we have in case the weather doesn't stick with us.
And theater is spelled?
T-H-E-A-T-R-E. org.
All right, thank you.
Thanks, Chris.
And I'm getting ready for this tremendous tour of Greater Boston and then Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia.
Exactly.
Exhausting. Thank you so much. Always good to see you.
You as well.
That's it for this edition of Neighborhood Network News. Chris Lovett and the rest of the gang will be back here on Monday night. We hope you'll join us then.